Pleasure to introduce Professor Wu, Wu Yongshi, Laoshi, from Utah. He's a distinguished university professor from Utah. But in the last almost 10 years now, right?
Yeah. Almost.
Almost, yeah. Professor Wu has been heading a very new and important center of theoretical physics. The formal name is actually Center for Field Theory and Particle Physics, and almost single-handedly established a group with specializations, of course, in topology, condensed metaphysics, and all related issues that are, most of you know, at the front line of research today. So, great pleasure to introduce Professor Wu, who will speak on stochastic quantization of Chern-Simons theory. And for a change, are you going to use the blackboard?
Yes.
The green one? That's the right way of doing things. That's what we're told when we're graduate students.
All the way.
Oh, that's right. Sorry.
And not fast in writing PPT files. Special co-author who meant to use blackboard.
This is a big one.
Okay, so this work, this workshop is serious. But recently, I'm interested in this field, but I not doing much work in this field. So my goal to come to the Congress actually is learn talks. Yeah. Who asked me? Talks. And I just mentioned my old work was in cooperation with my postdoc more than 10 years ago. This special issue is you. This issue was organized by Professor Namiki of Waseda University. My memory, actually, did not post this paper. well, stop, you know, that way, yeah, maybe tool for, unlock the system. We need to ask for customization, actually, we use, company creation as a basic tool. Starting, on the floor, louder.
Yes.
Yeah, so, we use, Langevin equation to, quantize, so, this, stochastic optimization as a way of optimization are, in parallel, so the canonic optimization and the path integral optimization. Stochastic optimization actually was particularly motivated by path integral. The name of stochastic optimization was really coined by Namu. Motivations. The first one is fundamental knowledge between path integral and classical. Of course, historically, also in optimization is analog is a formal one. Maybe if we consider the path integral map. Signature of space time. We have I action. Then integrate over all possible field configurations within this particular function. Only statistical mechanics side. Like ensemble, we know that, we have E to E minus E as the postman Higgs statistical weight. So, that means, so for Euclidean case, if we do the weak rotation, so the formal analogy actually is the analogy between the path integral in Euclidean field theory and the classical statistical mechanics. So then, in this way, formally, we say that the Canadian field theory, in the sense of its analog, is a system in equilibrium. I think yesterday, Professor Zhang mentioned is analog. All right, so usually textbook analogy is seven motivation is the following. Late 16th or the study of Confucius. The basic method is from color. Essentially, actually, the is analog to update the on-field configuration to minimize the action. So, sort of one was the motivation for this vocabulary was the region of the fields. Without for my person actually, I have thought about this a few years before the meeting, crazy and collaborating on that stock. In the middle of 70s, at that time, China was in a special period called the Cultural Revolution, quotation mark. I learned differential geometry from a mathematician Chinese Academy of Sciences. But,
say,
Liu Qigong.
Yeah, I know.
Then we know that, theory of gauge fields actually is closely theory of conductions and everything. So in the mathematics theory, I note that they can do with the classic theory of field theory without gauge fixing, because the emphasis is on the geometry. So gauge fixing actually is quite important. On the other hand, at that time, I began to work on gauge fields because at that time, Stanley model. There, we have to do this quantized gauge series. At that time, either in economic organization or in path, integral organization, in one thing is to engage things. Then we can develop preservation theory. Otherwise, the computer is not well defined because of the gauging parameters. Gauging bars means that language is that the degrees of freedom are redundant. Yeah. From the point of view of taking action, that means actually there are gauge orbits. The number of gauge orbits actually the value of actions. So then I was very curious why in physics quantized theory we have to fix the gauge, but however for mathematicians it's not this at all. So I met with the first Paris where I spent a few months in Paris when China's door was opened to St. Elizabeth in spring of 1907. Also, he was willing to visit China, so I arranged this is a spring of 80. Then we began to discuss some possibility for first, at that time, you know, the spring glass. So Parisi did the work. Then his advice is if he thought that his solution is good enough to exist for some time. So he suggested to me to look for another topic. Because I know that Parisi was good actually at the numerical simulation of gauge theory. And I noticed that there, actually, there's no need to fix it. From the color, you can start from arbitrary field configurations, which is update data. Right. So then we realized that we may try to put the idea of putting the color into some mathematical formulations. Putting on the color actually describes the process of a quantum field theory.
You mean at that time they were treating already on equilibrium systems with the quantum color?
I mean, when I use non equilibrium, actually, I mean, this okay, your system itself is a quantum field theory. However, if you try to sample the system. You are trying to get equilibrium distribution by updating the data. So the goal of Alo is to fund the distribution.
So there's actually switch amongst different configurations.
Right.
So in that sense, it's not really an audio, but it's a sample.
Right, yeah. Then, we know that we may try to mathematically formulate from non-equilibrium. I first suggest use for time, which and easily suggest use because we know that we can derive from okay, so finally we decide to start this. Okay, so this so essentially this idea of the system exam. When the equilibrium is reached, this analog. Analog itself here, just use this as some more distribution function.
Quantum is still.
Is still.
Still that.
Right. Yeah, but well, you have to draw, only use classical functions, classical numbers. No operators that you use, although in notation. So in nature, yeah, if you like. So the issue here, of course, is somewhat, and it's easy to remember what it is. However, the language sometimes confusing. Because here, E is a
C number.
Okay, so then of course the symbol somehow is to start with a size scale field. So to describe the so we consider Euclidean theory. Time. and coordinate, then we need to reduce a fictitious client. And finally, has to attempt to infinity to reach the equilibrium state. So this is Euclidean space-time. It's fictitious. Okay, then we can write down the boundary.
Can I ask you a question? Just jump in. What's noise, the source of noise in the world? I studied this a long time ago.
It was there.
Yeah.
It's white noise. Actually, you can use some, in some generalized form. The noises are not necessarily Gaussian. I'm going to measure that later.
You don't put it by hand, right?
I put it.
You do put it?
Right. So this S actually has to be S, okay? Euclidean action. But from now on, I just suppress. Subscript E. So this here, everything, also the beta.
Is your X four dimensional?
Right, yeah, this way.
So you can see the four dimensional.
So there is the shape of the top.
Mm-hmm, right. Then, order that. Theory, we have to distinguish between two kinds of average. First is average over eight. Then at the top to infinity, we have another average. That's average. So, in the sense of tending to the equilibrium here, it is anyone's, let's see, function of those space-time coordinates and fictitious. Then, argue that t to infinity, we recover the Euclidean homeomorphic theory. We consider the Fortran equation. Namely, we define the ability. Mm-hmm. Division Fire. Slough Fire. I think I'm gonna have a crew.
What is the subscript on Fire? Is it other function?
Here, Ada.
Is it Ada indicating?
Ada indicating the solution for the long-run equation. That's the running source.
Okay, and then you're subtracting it from the Fire.
Yeah, this is the function. So that is the solution has a value of Fire.
Independent of this form or at any point?
Yeah. So this guy is Fire and given ability for a accurate source, given function. So this is ability of solution function. Because here we use a tell function, which are basically
the distribution of language.
So we can prove that actually in a certain positive governance and the existence of AI, it's back to us.
Position representation of any function.
What?
Your, the delta functions.
Yeah.
Is that like a position representation of function functions?
Right, right.
It is.
That's what, yeah. But here, you only can see the configuration space. It's not, it's a phase space.
At this point, is your field, is your Fire operator or?
This notation, okay, Fire's self, you have some numbers in the value.
I don't think anything is an operator yet. If you start writing that question.
Right, then this, this thing here actually is just statistics, expect value.
Is a unique quantizer, so what point it becomes, we still have a bonus state of some sort.
No.
But,
yeah. So it's like in math, we just consider the infinite dimensional field configuration space. Space of field configurations. Okay? So essentially, from the long run equation point of view, we are considering a random walk in the field configuration space. This is the drift force, the classical, take mark, classical explanation of Euclidean action actually is spectral, which gives us a drift force. And Ada is a
if I may rephrase the true question, right? So the coherence properties in your original quantum system is now replaced, is it replaced now by some stochastic variable? And the quantum coherence property.
Right, yeah, so, that's here because there's some sort of scalar field. Yeah. It can be real field, or you can see the complex field. When you're talking about phase coherence, there, there is a phase of the complex.
But certainly the modern notion where the quantum gives way to classical through the coherent process, right? So the quantum phase, as in, for example, your density matrix, is no longer there, right? As soon as you write that.
There is some subtleties. Because in Gaussian space, if you say actually the so-called coherence and so on, it's always related to this kind of thing. So for mechanics, when we try to do the double split experiment, if we use this, we get inference. If we use this,
change your noise from white noise, for example, to color noise, you will get different answer by solving the function.
Right, yeah.
So what the meaning of E function?
We may add also some kernel term here. Then it's not necessarily function, but still the result is the same. So then
excuse me.
The 2K also.
Hmm?
Yeah, 2K, right?
2K, yeah, we have a 2K. Here, also we have a 2K.
Is 2K a same function?
K.
K.
K in the integral.
K is the same function. That's what I emphasized. The K has to be the same. Such that the final probability distribution, K, does not appear.
That looks to me like the noise curve, right? The noise curve, the K over there.
Right, right.
And you have to, in order to prove the existence or guarantee the FDR of the fluctuating dissipation relation, you must have some dissipation curve.
On the left hand side. Right.
Dissipation.
You call that this K as dissipation curve?
It's a noise curve.
It's a noise curve.
It's a correlation of your voice there, right?
Right, right.
That's where the color or noise comes from.
Okay. So for the, then after the Wuncom developed the pervasion theory over eta, when we tried to communicate this, then we can see that, yeah, we are able to reproduce the usual pervasion theory in the Euclidean scalars. I do not have time to, also, we need to generalize this. Complex number equation. Maybe, yeah. If, consider this phi as a complex field, then here we have a complex field. To reproduce ordinary quantum complex field theory, we need to assume that the eta, two possibilities, namely, one we consider the Minkowski space time. We need this one because actually this drifter force term, there should be an I there, drifter on this I. Therefore, the right hand side, when the drift force becomes complex, therefore the phi field itself has to be complex. So then we need to write a complex number equation. However, to reproduce the complex scalar theory Cauchy space, we need to keep eta real. Also, the initial field is supposed to be real. Then, in the middle, it becomes a complex field. But however, the final distribution from the Fokker-Planck equation, in which the probability is non-zero, only 1.53. Not then for gauge field. We can play some game. However,
each field, see where it pays, one go, yeah, and you know, acts, which you have, invariants and gauge formations. U one case, you have this one, this case, U half of this, plus, you know, theory is invariant. Then we do not need to fix A. Actually, if we do the revolution starting from Q to zero, we may choose. If the variable is not gauge invariant, stochastic polarization does not
work. So this is a crucial point because it's really motivated.
Right.
You have the tool there.
That's
you
right.
Color, you don't have to worry about gauge fixing.
Right.
So
right.
You have that, you gain the advantage
right.
By going over, basically.
That's
right.
Yeah, yeah.
Right.
So this is why I say, yeah, it's a motivated by this new art, but however we put it in a form of this long-run equation to describe. So when tau is finite, it's not, that's related to the topic of this.
The tau is not the real time, right?
Hmm?
The tau is not the real
it's not the real
time.
Okay. Well, so okay. However, there is a special class called logical see the term for that now. QCD. And, feel. It's just after the meal, I'm alone. Impro here. Has an excellent, okay? So, it's easy to show that this action is derivative. So classically, it does not contribute to the passing direction motion. However, it contributes to passing neural. We also added the most term or modular term to the one. In three dimensions, this land diagram is dimension free. Okay? Yeah. So finally, we use this term as actually the representation. This is a general rule, namely the Kabbalatka term always is purely natural. The reason is related to the weak rotation of because there must be an indices. Epsilon symbol, which is in time direction. If the action in the cosine space does not carry I in the Cayley space, it must carry I. Actually, if we consider the path integral mashup, the I is always there. In cosine space, we have this I. Okay, so the Kabbalatka action. Always associated with natural is always so because this is purely natural, we have to use complex numbers. Before us, actually, there were several groups. They try to apply stochastic optimization to apply the full theory. Everybody forgets. Yeah. Our paper was the first which that because I have noticed there's feature about that. Yeah, also in causing space, when they say that, usual term, high term, are the same. They transform different under interpretation. Yeah, so.
They always listen to the last. Very simple.
We need to consider that context. Another feature for the topological gauge theory is two features. One feature is as topological always carries a factor. Second feature is that usually to guarantee that we have an equilibrium at large fictitious pi, the Euclidean action has to be bounded from below. Always is positive. However, for the topological term, it can be either positive or negative. For example, we consider a number, which is a magnetic charge. It can be plus or minus 2, plus n, or minus. Yeah, because the epsilon is related to orientation. Okay, so both positive. So then, that's the f. It's not. But in the first even in the complex amplitude can interfere. So this is a topological function.
The interference really comes from the top of your sector.
Hmm? Right.
Right.
That's
just
right.
Topological, right? Yes.
That's right. Yeah. I solve the Langmuir equation average over 8. Thank you. that, yeah. Because what we have is, we take a letter and finish. Okay, wait. Then we can get. Get us one. All right, yeah, so, maybe, we'll keep this term here, just for the, exponential time of the, so for the, longitudinal part. Functions when you're away. So this is good. Then we may number of loops labeled by A and B. That's mu, C A, D, C A, this term here is called the number Gaussian number, and the one A to B itself. This is the standard result we could introduce on the previously. It's out of the factor I there.
What is this?
Some people could only do four more things because they ignore that I not do this computation. Yeah. NA is the yeah. Okay, so we were able to generalize the object, and we also use this tree. work home, she do it. This one, you have to take a special. Excellent. Flat the next one. Faster. So especially when I work hard. And we found that there is a shift of correction for the cap parameter in the transcendence. This is okay. So mathematically, when you choose polynomial, they always for SU2 case is plus 2. Okay. In quantum field theory, it's a loop shift. That's, you know, without I there. Four more things. They could not do our real computation. Verify. So then the finally, you know, the former success of the stochastic relation always made me think whether there are real interesting physics behind. I can mention one analog. In classic theory, we have a principle. It's a principle. We cannot ask why this principle is true, right? In the classic time. But however, for quantum mechanics, you know, we have the Feynman pattern. Feynman passing law, the classic limit is just
Settled,
right? Therefore, actually, passing law, Feynman's passing law, really makes sense of the variational principle in classical mechanics. Okay? That's not it. So here, I would like to ask a question. Whether there are further progress of the statistic conservation, namely, what's the meaning of this tau, what's the meaning of the Lambda equation, and the noise and so. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Very inspiring talk. One or two quick comment questions?
I don't understand the advantage of the stochastic quantization in phase tracing. In the standard quantization of phase theory, if you want to fix the K, let's say, problem, can that be avoided? Can you avoid?
Of course, yeah. Here, I forgot to make, here I consider a billing case. Well, not billing case. It can be shown that Fadeev Popov's ghost term, actually, not the effect of the ghost term, actually can be reproduced in the Lambda equation, correlation, or in stochastic.
What about this,
without gauge fixing.
Possible copies of the
then that's not necessary.
that can be avoided?
In a certain sense, you're passing, you avoid, because if you want to take a smooth hydro surface, so on, still there. Namely,
yeah,
if you try
to
go beyond
that. You have to take an age surface here.
That's right. Yeah. But however, you
can you derive this from stochastic condensation?
Yes. Yeah. It's
one loop.
Yeah.
In stochastic condensation.
Right.
All right, let's thank our speakers again.